I'm writing a lot of technical content online, and more often than not, I need to show code on a web page. And that code needs to be styled properly, because I cannot stand unstyled or wrongly styled code blocks, and I don't think I'm the only one. There are, of course, syntax highlighters that highlight code automatically. Highlight JS or Prism on the front end. There's Shiki, Torchlight, Highlight PHP, or PHP's built-in highlight file function on the backend. Now, I've tried all of them, and all of them have one or more problems. They are slow, they are inaccurate, especially when it comes to PHP highlighting, or they only support PHP. But what I need is something that works server-side, is fast, accurate, and easy to extend. So after trying out all available tools I could think of, I only saw one option left: to write it myself from scratch in PHP. I figured, how hard could it be? I started with the public API, how the user would interact with this package. That's definitely the simplest part. You pass in a string of code and you get a string of styled and escaped code back, which you can plop into an HTML page. So far, so good. Now, when it comes to highlighting, I figured there were two approaches I could take. Either parse the input into an abstract syntax tree, which is an accurate representation of the code, or use Regex to match words and patterns. Now, the benefit of an abstract syntax tree, an AST, is that it's super accurate. You know exactly which word is a keyword, a type, a property, and so on. Now, that's because an AST is a parsed version of the code you've given it. It knows about the language's parsing rules. The downside, however, is that you need an AST parser for every language you want to support. Now, PHP has a package for PHP. It's called PHP Parser and written by Nikita Popov. It's used, for example, by static analyzers like SAM or PHPStan. But I need to support a lot more languages than PHP. The bare minimum includes PHP, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, Blade, Twig, SQL, YAML, and JSON. Yeah, I'm not going to implement ASTs for all of those languages. So what about Regex? It's a lot easier to scale. It's just pattern matching on strings. It can become complex, but the patterns needed to highlight a programming language seem relatively simple. So I decided to explore the Regex route. I figured I'd make one class per matching pattern. Each class would represent one or a small number of things to match within our code. It would also return a token type, which would determine how a string should be colored. For example, keywords are blue, properties green, and types are red. Let's start with keywords, because they are the easiest to match by far. They are just hard-coded words reserved by the language. So I created a class, PHP language, that contains all my patterns for PHP, and I added keywords patterns to it. The highlighter would then loop over these patterns and check them one by one. If there is a match, that part would be wrapped within a span tag with a class. A couple of minutes later, and I had my first keyword colored. Next up, I added a pattern for function definitions and types, and it seemed to work. See? Not difficult at all. Right? I did have a suspicion that I might have missed some edge cases, because what if a function was called func and then replaced all occurrences of func with a colored span? Yeah, there were some edge cases to solve. Okay, so a simple string replace won't cut it. It doesn't know anything about overlapping or nested words, so I had to come up with something better. Here's an idea. What if we scanned the whole input at first? Every pattern that matches will add a token to an array. So now we have an array of tokens, each referencing a part of our string. Instead of doing a string replace, we can now target specific parts of our input at exact locations, because each token has a start and end position. So we can replace each part individually based on its position rather than its contents, which might overlap with other parts. We can also detect whether a newly added token belongs within another token or not. For example, func matches function, but function already has a keyword token attached to it. So based on that keyword token, we can determine whether a new token is allowed to exist within its parent scope. But let's say for now, though, that there cannot be any nested tokens, because That's easy. I replaced my string replace with a substring replace, lots of replacements all over the place, and it didn't work. I forgot about one important thing. We're relying on offsets to replace parts of our code, but as we're replacing parts, the offsets after those parts are actually changing. We're adding span tags all over the place. That's not a big deal though. We add a parsed offset variable that keeps track of how many characters have been added up until this point. If we take that number into account, then it works. Okay, with the basics of pattern matching in place, there is an important feature missing. We need a way to inject one language into another. It's a very common occurrence, CSS in HTML, HTML in JavaScript, PHP in HTML, or SQL in PHP. That's our test case, by the way, to figure this out, SQL in PHP. At first, I created a new language for SQL. And granted, it's a very basic implementation with only two keywords, but enough to get us started. I then made a test file, some PHP code containing an SQL query. We want our highlighter to highlight the PHP parts as PHP and the SQL parts as SQL. To do that, I added another concept besides patterns. Injections. An injection will also match a regex pattern, but instead of providing a token for that pattern, it will replace its match in full. In this case, we can match SQL queries because they are written within here docs that have the SQL delimiter within them. We write a regex for it and then replace the matched content with a re-rendered version of that content. In this case, we'll use the highlighter to re-render the SQL part as SQL. Next, I added injection support into the highlighter itself. It will run before all patterns are matched, and then it worked. SQL highlighting within PHP code. Now, these two concepts, patterns and injections, they are extremely powerful. Patterns highlight very specific parts of our code with as simple as possible regex matching, and injections replace big parts of code all at once. And of course, it took a lot of fine-tuning and smoothing over edge cases. It always does. But at the core, there isn't more to it than this. Patterns and injections. So I spent the last week and weekend on implementing support for several languages using this system, and it works great. I now have support for PHP, HTML, XML, JSON, YAML, CSS, Blade, Doc Commons, Dynamic Here Docs, JavaScript, custom highlight tags to emphasize or blur code, additions and deletions, and someone even added support for GDScript, which is used for Godot. From my perspective, I've reached the goals I set out to do. I have server-side syntax highlighting. It's super fast, it's easy to extend, and much more accurate when it comes to PHP highlighting than other tools. I switched my blog to it, fixed some more edge cases, and I'm pretty happy with the result. Of course, there will be more fine-tuning to do, but the core is solid and easy to work on. It's an open source package now, so you can use it if you want to, and you can check out the code as well. There's a link in the description. And while you're down there, leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.